Welcome everyone, Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and we've decided to take a hike to Mount Asangate, which is over here. And we're really close. There's a glacier lake that's right down there that we've been going to, and we're going to show you. But along the way, we've been walking along this pasture. Pasto, see?
Pasto.
Pasto.
Para comer desde los animales, albatas.
And right here we have, I know a lot of you guys wanted to know about how they prepare the potatoes, but these are chuños. And they are frozen, ¿sí? Helado.
Claro, por helada es chuño.
Sí.
Chuño este...
¿Cuántos días en el...
Casi una semana.
Sí, 1 week.
Una semana para helar.
So 1 week to freeze.
Claro, después para comer.
And then when they're done, they're ready. Y necesitamos cocinar, ¿sí?
Necesitamos cocinar.
Sí. So we need to cook them after we freeze dry them. But you'll notice I kind of figured out why they peel the potatoes here. Is because if you look right here, that's not a cob of corn. That's a little bit of alpaca dew.
Carne de alpaca.
Sí.
Para cocinar es potatoes. Puedes comer, o sea, así estás hablando con gente acá.
Yeah.
Así está, es alimento.
Sí.
Los mujeres, varones, todo va a comer.
Sí, everyone eats this, he says. Well, we camped out here last night, and see as the sun's coming up, there's just literally fields of ice. And Sebastian told us that it was a little bit warmer here. This is all ice down here, too. Said it was a little bit warmer than it was on the last trip that we took, but you know, I'm starting to believe that you just kind of go with the flow when you're hanging out with the Carol. Anyway, we'll show you the river or the lake in just a bit. If you look over here, there must be hundreds of alpaca. Yeah, just grazing in the pasture. Hundreds of them, just right before the mountain here. Hey, if I had fur like that, I'd hang out here too. There's not many people at all. Kind of sounds like a beach. But those birds. Sebastian just told me the name of them, but I forget. Quechua was really hard to kind of pick up. I know about 5 words. How pretty this is. This is a pretty special place here. As you can tell from all the rocks here, this all used to be ice. It used to be a huge glacier that would go down into the valley there. And you can see where we camped. It kind of has the same kind of feel, but there's running water here. This is pure glacier water. As long as we're north of the, or upstream of the alpacas, we should be okay to drink this mineral-rich water here. There's not much growth, though. You can see there's just a lot of low-lying. There's me and my hat. See, there's a lot of low-lying plants. You can see some of those yellow flowers. And that's about it. There's not much to eat up here. So you can see here, this is pure glacier water. You can see it up there. You can see Emery walking right up there. But coming down from here, if you wanted to grow some plants, now you couldn't grow it here because there's just no soil. It's all rock. But if you wanted to grow some serious food, some serious minerals, you'd want to take some of this water, bring it down the mountain, some good soil, and then you will have some incredible mineral-dense food, that's for sure. We just been here all day. All right, and here we are. As far as I know, this is as far up at Asangate as you can go. They may have trucks up to those peaks there, but I don't think you can go up there. Anyway, we're at about 16,000 feet. And the air is really thin here, so I'm catching my breath. But this glacier lake is frozen. And I think the joke's on us, because there was talk about swimming here. But I don't think that's going to happen today. What we're going to do is we're going to do a ceremony up here. We're going to do a despacho. And we're just going to enjoy the day. We're going to make some potato rice soup, because it's cold. And that's about it. And then we're just going to take some pictures here. Cool. One other thing, in case you're wondering, you see this hat here. You're wondering why this gringo's wearing this weird unique kind of hat. Let me take it off here. This is a tourist hat for sure, but I burn in the sun. But anyway, this hat here, I'll show you, is a traditional Caro hat, and you can see all the colors and the beads and everything, and you'll find the Caro wearing these all the time. Sebastian talked me into purchasing one because he said I needed one, whatever that means. And so this is it here. So the it's all hand woven. You can even see when you look inside, it's not as pretty because it is hand woven. Yep. And it's got neat little tail and puff balls and all this sorts of cool stuff, and it's super warm, and so that's really the main reason why I'm wearing it, because it's fantastically warm, and I can put my hat over it too, like most of the Caro do, to block the sun. So that is it.
It's special, because...
Well, it is special, yeah.
Gringos can't access to one.
Most, I guess. Well, anyway, hope you enjoyed today's little episodita. Today's actually Anne-Marie and my anniversary, 4 years married, so this is how we're spending it, a little bit different than the usual, but we're going to have a little fiesta up here, and we're going to dance apparently, and there's going to be music, so I have no idea what's going to happen. Sebastian brought his little tocana, which is a flute, and we'll see what happens. So your question of the day is this: how high, we're about 16,000 feet, how high have you been? I think I already asked that question before. Yeah, I've already asked that one before. We'll do a different one. If you are married, how many years? Go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together, we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.